Hello students, in the previous episode we studied different methods of charging and Coulomb's law in electrostatics. Today in this episode we are going to deal with relative permittivity or dielectric constant. In Coulomb's law we studied the electrostatic force between two charges. The electrostatic force between two charges is given by F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 by r square. So electrostatic force is given by F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 by r square that we studied in last episode. Here we know that F is the electrostatic force, q1 and q2 are the charges, and R is the distance between two charges. But this epsilon 0, we don't know what is this epsilon 0. Find what is epsilon 0. Epsilon 0 is known as the permittivity of air or vacuum. So epsilon 0 means permittivity of air or vacuum. Then what do you mean by permittivity? Permittivity is the ability of a substance to store electrical energy. It is the ability of a substance to store electrical energy. So permittivity is the ability of a substance to store electrical energy. So permittivity is the ability of a substance to store electrical energy in an electric field. That is an important point. In an electric field. Now we know that epsilon 0 is the permittivity of air or vacuum. Permittivity of air or vacuum. Here we are considering that if epsilon is the permittivity of any other medium except air or vacuum. We are considering that epsilon is the permittivity of any other medium except air or vacuum. Then here the ratio between these two values is known as relative permittivity. That means epsilon by epsilon 0 is known as relative permittivity. Or it is also known as dielectric constant. And we denote it by epsilon r or k. So here we can define relative permittivity as the ratio of permittivity of any medium to the permittivity of air is known as relative permittivity. So relative permittivity is the ratio of permittivity of any medium to the permittivity of air. Now we are considering two charges, charge Q1 and Q2, which is separated by a small distance r. And we know that the electrostatic force between these two charges F is given by F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by r square. If these charges are kept in air or vacuum. Only if the the charges are kept in air or vacuum, we can write the equation as F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. If the charges are kept in any other medium, then we can write the electrostatic force equation as follows. If the charges are kept in any other medium, so that we can write Fm. F in any other medium is equal to 1 by 4 pi. Instead of epsilon 0, we have to write epsilon because we are kept the charges in some other medium except air or vacuum. So the equation becomes 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. This is equation number 1. We know that epsilon by epsilon 0 is known as relative permittivity, right? The ratio of these permittivities is known as relative permittivity, and we denote it as epsilon R, or we can denote it as like K also, but here we are denoting it as epsilon R. So from this equation we can find out epsilon. Epsilon is equal to epsilon 0 epsilon R. Equation number 2. Now we are going to substitute equation number 2 in equation number 1. That means we get Fm is equal to 1 by 4 pi. Instead of epsilon, we can write epsilon 0 epsilon R. That means we already find that epsilon is equal to epsilon 0 and epsilon R. So here, instead of epsilon, we can write epsilon 0 epsilon R Q1 Q2 by R square. Just look at the equation. We know that 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. We already studied that 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. What is that? Yeah, we know that 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q1 Q2 by R square is equal to F. That means if the two charges are kept in air or vacuum, then the electrostatic force is given by F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. So we can substitute F instead of 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square in equation number 3. So we get Fm is equal to F by epsilon R, or we can write epsilon R is equal to F by Fm. So F by Fm. F is the electrostatic force between two charges which is kept in air or vacuum. And Fm is the electrostatic force between two charges if it is kept in any other medium except air or vacuum. Next topic is electric dipole. What is an electric dipole? It is a system of charges, system of equal and opposite charges. That means if I have minus Q charge, I'm taking another plus Q charge, and I am separated this charges by a small distance. We have a minus Q charge and a plus Q charge, and we separated these charges by a small distance. Then this system is known as electric dipole. So electric dipole can be defined as a system of two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance is known as electric dipole. Electric dipole is a system of two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance. We already said that electric dipole is two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance. Here, this distance is denoted as 2L. That is, the distance from minus Q to plus Q is taken as 2L. That 2L is known as length of electric dipole. Length of electric dipole. And it is denoted by 2L. The distance between the two charges is known as length of electric dipole and is denoted by